They say that a boat is nothing without water, and a man is nothing without his dreams. Well, for some of these boat owners, their dreams turned into nightmares. This is kind of like putting your car into cruise control and then heading to the back seat for a nap. And because of this, a family of trout were able to furnish their entire living room. That annoying moment when you get an alligator stuck in your propeller.
Oh my gosh!
When you try to launch your boat and your truck almost becomes a boat. On the other hand, there are times when your boat acts more like a car.
That's not supposed to.
I know what's wrong with it. It ain't got no gas in it.
This guy's a true rebel. He owns a trailer, but still refuses to use it. We all know how painful it is to be dumped, but it's so much worse when your boat does it to you. We shouldn't have to say this, but if you see a hornet's nest, don't hit it with a baseball bat.
All right, hold on, bitch. Oh, knock the shit out of him. Oh! Oh! Oh!
Well, they're filming it, so she's probably done something like this before. When you want to look like an action film star, but end up looking like a slapstick comedy film star. These airboats are often used in alligator-infested waters, which is why you never want this to happen. You may think it's cool to spray people with your boat, but only if you don't do it like a complete amateur.
Watch it down, VR!
Speed doesn't always get you out of a bad situation the fastest. When the fish you catch is slightly bigger than the usual variety, and even manages to get a few bites of its own in. If your boat is making a horrible crunching sound, you probably don't want someone filming it.
I'm just filming it in general. Film everything.
An exciting example of high speed sinking.
Missed the corner, but totally stuck the dismount. And it's sinking. All right, we've got one out. They're over there actually hoisting the boat out. They got it out. Good job, safety crew.
You have to assume there's a way of attaching that boat to that trailer. Like any bad captain, the owner of this boat has decided not to go down with it. Hopefully the price of this boat rental was worth it for the 3 seconds of pleasure they got. Yep, the water looks pretty shallow here. Ah yes, a beautiful stormy day. Perfect weather to take out my sailboat. Having a big yacht does not mean you can't handle a big storm. These guys clearly didn't think it was a good idea to avoid that big green grassy thing we usually call land. You should never see how many people you can get in a boat. It's not a clown car. Sadly, it takes more than a bucket to remove the entire ocean from your boat.
I may not be a smart man, but
Here's a romantic coupling that nobody wants to be a part of. when he tries to get that out of the water again, he's suddenly going to remember what a ramp is. How to launch a boat, James Bond style. Some people find barnacles on their boat. This guy found his wife. You've heard the phrase, like a fish out of water, right? Well, sometimes it's worse when they go back in. You don't need circus skills to get out of a boat, but it helps. You know that Irish river dance? This is kind of similar. One of those moments when you realize you should keep a bucket on board.
Holy! Oh my God!
Why use a car to launch your boat when you can use a couple of idiots? When it comes to the most common boating fails, the low bridge has to be top three. How to dive straight into a puddle of humiliation. See if you can count how many passengers are left at the end of this high-quality bit of boat piloting. Another bridge that wasn't high enough, although the guy navigating the boat clearly was. No, this is not a trailer for the new Tesla. This is what a hit and run looks like on water. Ah, the amusement that can only come from a near drowning. You get the impression that these guys spent less time catching fish and more time drinking like them. You don't have to be a marine engineer to know that this isn't good. Can anyone hear that Celine Dion song playing? Never bump and grind on a boat. They're not good tippers. Yeah, I'll just tip this water out, and that should solve the problem completely. More people own boats than can pilot boats. That's a scientific fact.
Oh boy, oh, there goes. Oh boy, oh, there goes. Boom, welcome to the chit show, guys.
When boats get jealous. And now a new water-based comedy duo. Sometimes lifeboats can take on a life of their own. If this guy had ever put his aerial down before going through the car wash, then he would have thought twice about this. This is the boating equivalent of one of those buffering wheels. This is either some irresponsible boat piloting, or he really needs a toilet. Here's someone who's clearly not familiar with the concept of the tide going in and out. The dock rail slide. How many points is that in Tony Hawk Pro Skater? Some free advice from Akimbo. Don't use your leg to stop a speeding boat.
Wow, that hurt.
Dogs will always chase a stick, no matter how wet the floor is. And speaking of dogs, I think we can all see that this one is one of the most intelligent creatures in this clip. This boat is about as useful as a surfboard. And now another bit of water rage as this guy flees the scene of the accident. Kinda get the feeling their car parking skills are not much better. The only thing they're going to catch is a near-death experience. How to look absolutely stunningly dumb. What you don't see in this video is one of the loops catching the bow and flipping the boat. Luckily, there were no injuries. What do you do when your nearby river is flooded? You find a fellow idiot and you go out on your raft, of course. Somebody better tell her it hasn't started yet. Yep, there's always an annoying guy called Dave.
Don't give him a cubby, go Dave. Yep, he's just too good.
Always a good idea to make sure the boat isn't still attached to the trailer. If you get asked to turn your music down by guys on jet skis, then you might want to oblige. They've got a secret weapon. Don't watch the fishing rod, watch the guy in the speedboat. And listen to that big crack he makes when he realizes he can't drive it. This guy brought his boat home to clean it, so the rain decided to help him out. If you plan to catch a squid, then make sure you're not wearing a white shirt. Luckily, no cameras were harmed in the filming of this accident. This woman gives new meaning to the phrase headbanging. Yeah, this fits like a glove. A really, really, really tight glove. No beer left behind. Apparently, what would be terrifying for most people is fun for these guys. Sometimes you catch a fish, and sometimes a fish catches you. That old, I've forgotten there's a boat in the back of my car moment. Some fishing boats just aren't equipped to deal with this level of fishing success.
I'm so close.
Nothing helps remove that sinking feeling like an Akimbo video. So help us stay afloat by clicking subscribe.